close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care if they call me crazy. We can live in a world that we desire. Feels like home. They can see
say that can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care if they call me crazy. We can live in a world that we design. Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me awake. I think of what the world could be, a vision of. There's a house we can build. Every room inside is filled with things from far away. Special things I compile, each one there to make you smile on a rainy day. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say we've lost our minds. See, I don't care if they call us crazy. Run away to a world that we desire. Of the one I see.
Bless them with peace, that they may know your joy. Bless them with vision, that they may live with purpose. Bless them with strength, that they may challenge injustice. Bless them with love, that they may be your love in the world. Bless them with faith, that they may recognize your loving presence. Gracious God, hear the prayers that we make for the graduating students. Hold them, enfold them, embrace them, and protect them. We ask this in the name of Jesus, the light of the world. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Ruby and Annabelle. I would now like to invite our college principal, Mrs. Sharon Quirk, to the lectern to give her principal's address to the graduating class of 2022.
Can't see you all. So, dear parents, guardians, members of staff, and most importantly, the graduating class of 2022. Today can only be viewed as a remarkable occasion as I stand before you, the class of 2022. To this class, I say congratulations. Your achievement in reaching this stage in your education is something for which you should be justifiably proud. You have worked hard to be here, and you deserve to be honoured in the most public manner. But I use the word stage in your education because you being here today is in effect the commencement of your next pathway. It is the commencement of the process by which control over what you do and how you respond to challenges you may face now moves from your parents and guardians to you. The people here with you today remain ever ready to provide you with advice and guidance, but it is now you who will determine who you are in life, the values by which you will be known. We are all different. We think differently and have different abilities and different interests. But what we have that is the same or similar are shared values and common behaviours which distinguish us as a Brigidine community. Just as your parents and guardians made a choice for you to attend this college, you now assume the responsibilities for the choices that will shape your lives and the lives of those around you. And let me assure you, it is exciting. When you leave this college, know that it does not leave you. Thank you very much. Seize what is before you and be bold in your demands on life. For to settle for less is to embrace mediocrity and thereby limiting your potential. None of you know what it is you are capable of, and this is as it should be. If I could impress upon you three qualities or pieces of advice for you to consider this time forward, they would be the following. First, strive for significance in your life. Second, embrace disappointment as opportunity. Third, develop a plan about which you have a passion and follow it through without compromise in a committed, honest manner. If you are able to pursue these three things, you will be true to yourself, and your time spent at this college will have prepared you well for your commencement in life. You have heard me speak about striving for significance, but what does that actually mean? You are entering a world where thousands of others just like you. It is also a world where thousands have been before you and are still out there. Do not, however, assume there is an order as to what you can do or how you can seek to impose yourself on a place, a circumstance, or an opportunity. Your direction from here is not defined by who you have been to this point, but rather what it is you choose to do from this point. Perhaps the most simple and relatable comment I can make is to say that when you leave here, do not line up as you would at Coles to pursue sequentially your opportunity to visit the checkout. No. Find a way, find your way to navigate to the front of the queue. We often speak of being successful in life, and success is a wonderful thing that we are all capable of achieving in modest or substantial proportions, but it can also be fleeting. I want to challenge each of you to be successful in what it may be that you turn your minds to, but I also want you to think further to something that is not fleeting, that is more lasting. For each of you is also capable of this challenge, and you can find your niche. You will create significance in your life and that of those around you. Significance is about a lasting effect. While dangerous to define, it may be as a parent, it may be as a volunteer, it may be as a musician, it may be as a writer, it may be through your research, it may be through your humanitarian work. Its effect is only limited by your imagination. In the words of Dr. Nido Cobain, who's the president of High Point University in North Carolina, he says, success does not guarantee joy. To turn success into joy adds significance and fulfillment. So while success is important, my challenge to you over the next 30 years is to define your significance. And when you do, write and tell us here at Brigidine. Put it on a social media post. Tell us. Sing loudly of how you make your significant mark in this world. For our pride in your success and significance will never diminish. In a strange way, creating significance leads me to my second point. Namely, I want you all to embrace disappointment, because if you can, it will mean you will never give up. And while embracing of disappointment may seem like a curious statement to make, many aspects of your life from this point will contain some element of disappointment, where you are not fully happy with the outcome of something. Embracing disappointment is a far cry from me suggesting that you should embrace failure. Rather, disappointment is often a measure that your expectations have not been met. And when you pause to think about this, it is how things should be for people such as yourselves, who are highly motivated to achieve and for whom the expectation bar has been set very high. Learn from disappointment and understand you have three options. Let it affect you and sadden your approach in life. Let it scare you and instill a reluctance to try again. Or let it motivate you to reset your thinking and approach to the future. I am confident that each of you will reset and continue to set high expectations in your life. Imagine a circumstance where you're able to achieve everything in life that you set out to do. What would that be telling you? Perhaps it may be telling you that your expectations have not been set high enough. Your potential may not have been fulfilled. So how can you measure your expectations and learn from disappointment? Challenge yourselves. Challenge yourselves to want more in all you do. Do not settle for mediocrity or the easy solution, as easy is rarely the best. Think critically and strategically, not just for the moment, but well beyond that. Embrace your maturity and understanding the relationship between your decisions and the effects these decisions have on others. Develop your wisdom and understand who you can turn to for advice, not for similar ideas that reinforce those of your own, but independent, objective counsel. Delight in different views and approach them with an inquiring mind. Treat them as opportunities to learn, not threats. Your life cannot be an echo chamber that serves only to reinforce your own opinion. Use your education to understand the world around you. Form your own opinions and hold on to them strongly, but not unreasonably. Seek out and nurture friends, but those who are true, noting that there will be many standing with you in the Coles line who seek to take advantage of you and leverage from your talents. True friends are accepting of you without question. They are usually very few in number, but will always stand with you, guiding you, encouraging you, urging you to seek and fulfill your place in this world, to make your mark of significance. Be prudent. Be prudent about your social media usage and understand the ubiquitous nature of the information world in which you have been born. Collaborate with others and give trust, knowing that it is for someone else to lose. If you remain aware of these simple pieces of advice, your expectations will remain high, and you will continually challenge yourselves to want more from life. Yes, there may be disappointment, but there will be so much more that is well worth it. But in saying this, you must also have fun. Embrace life, see its beauty in each and every day, and be grateful. Enjoy yourselves and remember that life is a marathon, not a sprint. It has to be fueled by the proper balance, but know where you're going and stay true to yourself. Leads me to my third point. Have a plan. In saying this, do not be concerned if you're uncertain about where you were going or what you were doing. This is just a part of life, and that is also the fun. But we all have dreams. I challenge each of you, therefore, to move toward making your dream a reality. Why would you not want to realize your dream? Your dream can be your pathway to a plan. So after the water has been tested and you understand your dream, develop your plan for how you are going to get to where you want. Be bold and think of the end state first and understand what you need to do to get there. If you can visualize it, it can be reached. We all work in different ways, and I'm often confronted by people who have well-developed plans. And while it may be easy to applaud the fact that they do, when I speak to them about the fact that they have more than one plan, it is often because they have a plan to reach their dream, but they have another plan just in case it does not happen. I say to each one of you, dare to dream. Have one plan. Do not be confused or distracted by several plans, because if you do, you will find that you're compromised on your dream. Know where you want to go and pursue it. You will not fall because you have the support of everyone in this room to be significant in your life. I say to you all, when you understand where you want to go, follow your dream with a passion, embracing every success and disappointment that inevitably will come your way. Find your passion, and when you do, know that it is yours. Your passion cannot be what someone else tells you it is. For if you let someone define your passion looks like, you'll be selecting an insincere and unstable pathway. Will it be easy? No. Will it be smooth? Probably not. But in order to be true to yourself, you need to exhaust every possibility. When you hit the wall, does your plan stop? Or will you identify a way to get to the other side of the wall? When someone says it can't be done, do you accept this and abandon your plan? Or do you ask yourself, why not? Or what if? When you find yourself alone, are you going to stop? Uncertain that no one appears to be following? Or are you going to determine yourself to go on and realize your dream? Class of 2022, be excited by this moment. I know you have a lot in front of you, but also know that we are here to support you. Make your dreams your new reality. Draw strength from your disappointment and see it as a challenge. Lead a life not of success, but of significance. On this day, your graduation day and the 56th internationally recognized Day of Gratitude, I say thank you. Thank you for the amazing contribution you have made to this college. Thank you for providing an example to our younger students that speaks of all that it means to be a Brigidine girl, a girl of compassion, hope, justice, hospitality, courage, and service, a girl of grit, of passion, of warmth, of strength, of love. Thank you for your incredible perseverance, your diligence, your amazing positivity, and your zest for life. You have brought much joy to this college, and for this, above all, I am grateful. Thank you. Thank you. At times, when our own light goes out and is rekindled by a spark from another person, each of us has cause to think with deep gratitude of those who have lighted the flame within us. Congratulations on your graduation day and the commencement of a wonderful and exciting journey ahead. Thank you for being Brigidine girls who walk with fortiter et suaviter. To the class of 2022, we all, in this hall and every corridor of Brigidine College, say thank you. We are proud of who you are and embrace the opportunities we hope that lay in front of you. Know that you have left a legacy. Know that you have left a legacy that we will speak of often and acknowledge with much fondness the impact you have made to make our college richer. Grab life with both hands and please enjoy the ride, for it is yours to take. Congratulations, girls. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Quirk. We will now commence the ceremony by announcing the graduates of 2022. It is with pleasure and pride that we acknowledge the achievement of completing 13 years of schooling. This afternoon, these young women will graduate in houses. May I ask that you hold your applause until each house graduates. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Alana Muhammad, the pastoral care teacher for Aquinas. Joining all of our teachers on the stage to present our students with their graduation folder will be our college principal, Mrs. Sharon Quirk.
Mrs. Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduands of Aquinas House. Nikita Agirathabal. Jaya Curtis. Yeah, Giovanni DeLaget, College Faith and Charism Captain. Lily Early. Juliet Fluke. Kira Herford. Rose Johns. Kira Keldoulis. Eliza Lee. Artissa Morton. Danielle Metopoulos. Sienna Nevitt. Evangeline Panis. Eliza Pizzonato. Joanna Prammer. Ariella Richards. Audrey Sito. Macy Smith, Aquinas House Captain. Angelina Filavitis. Rosie Sakunas, Aquinas House Captain. Sophia Vedder. And Carmen Ewan. Let us congratulate 12 Aquinas. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Kylie Little, the pastoral care teacher for Bridget.
Miss Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduates of Bridget House. Ginevra Aiello. Alyssa Aramani. Stella Belatowski. Christelle Cabrera. Maya Cajillas Martinez. Aletta Darwood. Zersha Early. Maria Francis. Isabella Greensmith. Sophie Hammond, Bridget House Captain. Caitlin Hickey. Mira Jackson, College Captain. Amy Kawachindachai. Good girl, Amy. Tamsin Lawrence. Georgia Maidment. Matisse McDonald. Emily Murray, Bridget House Captain. Eleni Nicholas. Levi Norrish. Angelica Pardinas. Tegan Purbrick. Maria Richards. Ivana Solaro. Simeon Stevens. Let us celebrate 12 Bridget. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Alethea Scors, the pastoral care teacher for Delaney.
Mrs. Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduates of Delaney House. Chanel Arrogante. Ella Bennett. Ciara Cameron. Holly Clatworthy. Abigail Connolly, College Arts and Culture Captain. Chloe Day. Julia Dedushuk. Haley Rose Ellis. Erin Mary Fleming. Natalie Ho. Chloe Kalagarakis, Delaney House Captain. Yeah, Hannah Kent. Cynthia Leong, College Vice Captain. Rebecca McCarter. Sophia Massey. Jade Michalaitis, Delaney House Captain. Lily Moss. Indigo Murray. Eve Payne. Mia Ray. College Social Justice Captain. Harley Rogers. Isabella Suijawa. Ruby Studdard. Sophia Zaru. Let us congratulate 12 Delaney. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Sarah Gooley, the pastoral care teacher for Regina Mundy.
Mrs. Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduates of Regina Mundy House. Olivia Alvarez. Ooh. Tatiana Attard, Regina Mundi, House Captain. Karina Bergen. Alexandra Coughlin. Leah Doyle, Regina Mundi, House Captain. Isabella England. Olivia Finnick. Scarlett Graham. Alyssa Haig. Talia Kepo. Eliza Kipperman. Chelsea Long. Beatrice Littlewood. Philippa Mangione. Daniela McHenry. Alexandra McHale. Amelia O'Connor. Charlotte Pinsawood. Emma Power. Leah Rowley. Daniela Siljig. Ava Sabo. Riley Turbin. Eleni Triantafylou. Sophie Van Willer. Let us congratulate 12 Regina Mundi. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Patrice Anderson, the 12th pastoral care teacher for Winifred. Thank you.
Mrs. Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduands of Winifred House. Sarah Alley. Madeline Bald. Indy Blagg. Isabella Cardno, Winifred House Captain. Kaladi Shambiris. Annalise Choi. Poppy Cousins. Amelia De Torre. Sophie Ferenczi, Winifred House Captain. Joyful Fotu Mawala, College Sports Captain. Zoe Gray. Gabrielle Hayes. Zoe Kander. Giselle Klotz. Paige Lopez. Erin Malone. Molly Martin, College Sustainability Captain. Marissa Mills. Lily Murray. Hayley O'Keefe. Sienna Rainers. Savannah Russo. Grace Simpson. Ruby Thomas Hugh, College SRC Captain. Gabriella Wahib. Cora Walsh. Let us congratulate 12 Winifreds. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Mrs. Kate Elder, the pastoral care teacher for Xavier.
Mrs. Quirk, I present to you the Year 12 graduands of Xavier House. Sienna Anderson. Genevieve Beach. Bronte Booth. Yes, Eliza Cantarella. Milena Cortez. Isabella DiFrancesco. Katie Ford. Elizabeth Gutsis, Xavier House Captain. Ivory Heidenreich. Charlie Hott. Ava James. Samantha Kay. Imogen Lucas. Lucia Martin Mortez, Xavier House Captain. Jessamy Miles. Emily Morrison. Alice Norbury. Isabella Palm. Isabella Pisanos. Jasmine Pringo Hajono. Madison Ray. Maria Ribeiro. Nicholas Seaman. Sophie Shepherd. Brielle Smith. Jade Tran. Lola Williams. Let us congratulate Year 12 Xavier.
Thank you very much. Girls, there are many symbols that signify your graduation, but none other than the graduation tassel. It is a symbol of success. When you entered for your graduation today, you placed the tassel on the right-hand side of your cap. As you have successfully completed your secondary education and walked the stage, a symbolic gesture of crossing over from high school to your next stage in life is to move the tassel on your cap to the left. May I ask the Brigidine College graduating class of 2022 to please stand. Please take your tassel and move it from the right side of your cap to the left. And that deserves a round of applause. Thank you, girls. You have officially graduated. Please be seated.
Thank you, ladies. I would now like to invite to the lectern Ms. Eleonora Agazzi, our Director of Curriculum, to conduct the presentation of the Conatus Awards.
It is my absolute pleasure to commence the award ceremony by acknowledging the dedication and effort of a number of our U12 students. Across semester 1 and 2, our U12 students have been awarded an effort grade. The effort grade is determined by a student's application and approach to learning throughout a semester. In 2022, we acknowledge student effort through the Conatus Award. Conatus is the Latin for effort, and with this award, we recognise students who consistently apply themselves and approach learning with tenacity and a desire to strive for their personal best. The Conatus Award is awarded to students who have maintained a grade point average of 5 across both semesters. To achieve a 5-point GPA, students have achieved an A grade for effort across all subjects studied at the college in semesters 1 and 2. In 2022, the Conatus Award is presented to the following students. Tatiana Attard. Madeline Bald. Genevieve Beach. Kira Cameron. Eliza Cantarella. Annalise Choi. Holly Clatworthy. Isabella Di Francesco. Sophie Ferenzi. Aletta Dowd. Katie Ford. Joyful Fotu Moala. Maria Francis. Elizabeth Gutsis. Zoe Gray. Alyssa Hay. Sophie Hammond. Caitlin Hickey. Charlie Hott. Mira Jackson. Samantha Kay. Beatrice Littlewood. Daniela McHenry. Marissa Mills. Emily Morrison. Danielle Matopoulos. Alice Norbury. Eve Payne. Mia Ray. Leah Rowley. Ruby Thomas Yu. Eleni Trantafalou. Sophie Von Willer. Gabriella Wahib. Please join me in congratulating all of our award recipients. I would now like to invite Ms. Natasha Fox, our Director of Learning and Innovation, to conduct the presentation of the Academic Awards.
It is my absolute pleasure to conduct the presentation of the Academic Awards. Could I ask that you please hold your applause until each department's awards have been received? I would like to invite the Director of Religious Education and Mission, Miss Jamie Lee Wood, to join Mrs. Quirk for the presentation of the awards in religious education. The medal for first place in Studies of Religion 2 is presented to Mira Jackson. Second place in Studies of Religion 2 is presented to Genevieve Beach. Equal third place in Studies of Religion 2 is presented to Charlie Hott. Equal third place in Studies of Religion 2 is also presented to Cynthia Leong. The medal for first place in Studies of Religion 1 is presented to Sophie Von Wheeler. Equal second place in Studies of Religion 1 is presented to Zoe Gray. Equal second place in Studies of Religion 1 is also presented to Philippa Mangione. Equal second place in Studies of Religion 1 is also presented to Jade Tran. The medal for first place in Studies in Catholic Thought is presented to Kira Herford. Second place in Studies in Catholic Thought is presented to Angelica Pardinas. Third place in Studies in Catholic Thought is presented to Ruby Studdett. Please join me in congratulating all the award recipients for religious education. Thank you, Miss Wood. I would like to invite the Head of English, Miss Natalia Hennessy, to join Mrs. Quirk on the stage for the presentation of the English Awards. The medal for first place in English Advanced is presented to Genevieve Beach. Genevieve also receives the medal for first place in English Extension 1. Second place in English Advanced is presented to Mira Jackson. Third place in English Advanced is presented to Zoe Gray. The medal for equal first place in English Standard is presented to Rosie Tasakunas. the medal for equal first place in English Standard is also presented to Sophie Von Wheeler. Third place in English Standard is presented to Philippa Mangione. The medal for first place in English Studies is presented to Ruby Studdett. Equal second place in English Studies is presented to Alyssa Armani. Equal second place in English Studies is also presented to Maya Cajas Martinez. Please join me in congratulating our English Award recipients. Thank you, Miss Hennessy. I would like to invite our Director of Curriculum, Ms. Eleonora Agazzi, to present the Drama Awards. The medal for equal first place in drama is presented to Matisse McDonald. The medal for equal first place in drama is also presented to Jade Michalidis. Third place in drama is presented to Eleni Triantafylou. Please join me in congratulating our Drama Award recipients. Thank you, Ms. Agazzi. I would like to invite Mr. David Nally, our Head of Human Society and its Environment, to present the HISI Awards. The medal for first place in ancient history is presented to Leah Rowley. Second place in ancient history is presented to Eve Payne. The medal for first place in business studies is presented to Mira Jackson. Second place in business studies is presented to Eleni Triantafylou. The medal for first place in economics is presented to Danielle Moutopoulos. The medal for equal first place in geography is presented to Sophie Forenzi. Yeah, the The medal for equal first place in geography is also presented to Sophie Von Wheeler. Third place in geography is presented to Ruby Thomasu. The medal for first place in legal studies is presented to Mia Ray. Mia also receives an award for second place in economics. Second place in legal studies is presented to Daniela McHenry. Daniela also receives an award for third place in business studies. Third place in legal studies is presented to Alice Norbury. The medal for first place in modern history is presented to Genevieve Beach. Second place in modern history is presented to Eleni Nicholas. Third place in modern history is presented to Molly Martin. The medal for first place in history extension is presented to Maria Richards. Please join me in congratulating our HISI award recipients. Thank you, Ms. Denali. I would now like to call upon our Head of Languages, Mrs. Janine Christofides, to present the Languages Awards. The medal for first place in Italian Continuers is presented to Ginevra Aiello. Please join me in congratulating Ginevra. Thank you, Mr. Christofides. I would like to invite our Head of Mathematics, Mrs. Maya Mabey, to join Mrs. Quirk for the presentation of the Mathematics Awards. The medal for first place in Mathematics Extension 1 and Mathematics Extension 2 is presented to Sophie Von Wheeler. Second place in Mathematics Extension 1 is presented to Mira Jackson. Mira is also presented with second place in Mathematics Advanced. Equal third place in Mathematics Extension 1 is presented to Elizabeth Gutsis. Equal third place in Mathematics Extension 1 is presented to Cynthia Leong. Yes, Cynthia. Cynthia is also presented with third place in Mathematics Advanced. the medal for first place in Mathematics Advanced is presented to Eliza Cantarella. The medal for first place in Mathematics Standard 2 is presented to Sophie Haman. Equal second place in Mathematics Standard 2 is presented to Philippa Mangione. Equal second place in Mathematics Standard 2 is presented to Lucia Martin Mortez. The medal for first place in Mathematics Standard 1 is presented to Amy Kawachindachai. Second place in Mathematics Standard 1 is presented to Hayley O'Keefe. Please join me in congratulating all recipients of our Mathematics Awards. Thank you, Miss Maybe. I would like to invite the Head of Music, Mrs. Jacqueline Hanafy, to present the Music Awards. The medal for first place in Music 1 is presented to Chloe Kalajarakis. The medal for first place in Music 2 is presented to Mira Jackson. Please join me in congratulating our Music Award recipients. Thank you, Miss Hanafy. I would now like to invite our Head of Personal Development, Health and Physical Education, Mrs. Vanessa Colhane, to present the PDHPE Awards. The medal for first place in Community and Family Studies is presented to Emma Power. Second place in Community and Family Studies is presented to Kaladi Shambaris. Third place in Community and Family Studies is presented to Beatrice Littlewood. The medal for first place in Personal Development, Health and Physical Education is presented to Ruby Thomasu. Second place in Personal Development, Health and Physical Education is presented to Imogen Lucas. Third place in Personal Development, Health and Physical Education is Jade Tran. Woo-hoo! Please join me in congratulating our award recipients for PDHPE. Thank you, Mrs. Colhane. I would like to invite our Head of Science, Mrs. Tess Waterhouse, to present the Science Awards. The medal for equal first place in biology is presented to Genevieve Beach. The medal for equal first place in biology is also presented to Sophie Von Wheeler. The medal for first place in chemistry is presented to Cynthia Leong. Cynthia is also presented with an award for third place in biology. Second place in chemistry is presented to Eliza Lee. The medal for first place in physics is presented to Gabriella Wahib. The medal for first place in science extension is presented to Sophia Massey. Please join me in congratulating our Science Award recipients. Thank you, Mrs. Waterhouse. I would like to again invite our Director of Curriculum, Ms. Eleonora Agazzi, to present the awards for Technology and Applied Studies. The medal for first place in Design and Technology is presented to Sophie Ferenzi. Second place in design and technology is presented to Sophie Haman. Third place in design and technology is presented to Gabriella Wahib. Please join me in congratulating our TAS Award recipients. Thank you, Ms. Agazzi. I would like to invite our Head of Visual Arts, Ms. Melissa Nutter, to present the Visual Arts Awards. The medal for first place in Visual Arts is presented to Imogen Lucas. Equal second place in visual arts is presented to Kaladi Shambaris. Equal second place in visual arts is also presented to Eliza Pizzanato. Please join me in congratulating our Visual Arts Award recipients. Thank you, Ms. Nutter. I would like to again invite our Director of Curriculum, Ms. Eleonora Agazzi, back to the stage to present the VET Awards. The medal for first place in business services is presented to Jade Michalidis. Second place in business services is presented to Nicola Seaman. Third place in business services is presented to Sophia Vedder. The medal for first place in hospitality is presented to Marissa Mills. Second place in hospitality is presented to Philippa Mangione. Equal third place in hospitality is presented to Madeline Bold. Equal third place in hospitality is presented to Indy Blagg. Please join me in congratulating our VET Award recipients. Ms. Agazzi will remain on stage to present the New South Wales School of Languages Awards with Mrs. Quirk. Excellent effort and commitment to Chinese beginners is presented to Audrey Sito. First place in German extension is presented to Charlie Hott. Charlie also receives an award for excellent effort and commitment in German continuers. Second place in Italian extension is presented to Ginevra Aiello. Please join me in congratulating our language award recipients. Thank you, Ms. Agazzi. And once again, a big round of applause to all of our academic award recipients this afternoon. Thank you.
Good afternoon, all. This afternoon, I have the privilege of presenting a very unique award for a wonderful group. This award is a first for Bridgetine College, potentially a first for New South Wales, and a first for Australia that we know of. The award recognises the skills and capabilities determined critical for the future success by the World Economic Forum. Credentialing is the process of recognising the abilities and experiences that make someone suitable for a particular job or activity and offers a portable proof of these abilities and experiences. This credentialing is usually reserved for executives in business and postgraduates. I'd like to welcome to the stage the wonderful Dr. Rick van der Swan, Director of Science from the Human Capability Intelligence Centre, HCIC. I've had the pleasure of working with Rick for about 4 or 5 years to get this up and running, and it's a very wonderful experience. And thank you, Ms. Quirk, for being able to give this platform to us to offer this award to my wonderful Year 12 Design Technology class. By undertaking the rigors of the major design project, our design students have shown to have met or exceeded the micro-credentials for communication, critical thinking, and creativity. For this reason, Rick is here today to present the design and technology students with an award recognition of these micro-credentials. Can I please have the Year 12 Design and Technology class ready to come up? I'll just say your first name and then we'll all gather down here for one very unique little photo. Nikita. Sarah. Milena. Giovanni. Aletta. Leah. Sophie. Sophie Hammond. Rebecca. Jade. Emily. Atissa. Isabella. Angelica. Isabella. Joanna. Jasmine. Sienna. Maria. Gabriella. And Lola Williams. Congratulations, Year 12 Design and Technology.
It is now time in the ceremony when we present the special awards. Our first award this afternoon is the Catholic Education Foundation Social Justice and Excellence in Learning Award. To present this award, I would like to invite to the stage Maria Soufis from Sydney Catholic Schools to present our award.
Good afternoon, everyone. This award is granted to a student who leads by example, displays empathy and compassion, is actively involved in social justice activities while having a consistent approach to her studies, and displays personal learning excellence. It is my pleasure to announce the recipient of this award, Ruby Thomasew.
Our next award is the Duke of Edinburgh Gold Award, and I invite to the stage Ms. Taylor Whiteman to assist Mrs. Quirk with the presentation. The Duke of Edinburgh's International Award is a leading youth development program empowering young Australians to explore their full potential and to find their purpose, passion, and place in the world. This year, we acknowledge four students who attained the Gold Award. Each of these students has demonstrated leadership, tenacity, and strength of character. It is my pleasure to announce the recipients of this award. Tatiana Attard. Mira Jackson. Eliza Lee. Ariella Richards. Thank you, Ms. Whiteman. Our next two awards will be presented by a representative of the Australian Defence Force. It is my pleasure to welcome to the stage Warrant Officer Jason Ayres to announce these awards.
Principal, Mrs. Quirk, staff, parents, students of Bridgetown College, and especially the graduating class of 2022. Thank you for inviting me as a representative of the Australian Defence Force to present the 2022 ADF Future Innovators Award. I'm Warrant Officer Jason Ayres, and I've served in the Royal Australian Navy for 35 years. I currently work at Fleet Base East Garden Island. Your school is one of 2,300 Australian schools that has participated in the ADF Future Innovators Award program this year. The ADF Future Innovators Award recognises Australian students who demonstrate motivation and innovation in science, technology, engineering and mathematics. I'm glad to be here today to present this award. The work we undertake would not be possible without STEM capable people. I work alongside talented tradespeople and technical professionals who ensure some of the most technically advanced equipment in Australia can be drawn upon to achieve what we need to achieve. I'm here today because the Australian Defence Force's requirement for innovators, critical thinkers and problem solvers, and there are many opportunities for future innovators in the Navy, Army and Air Force. The ADF contributes to the nation in many ways, from assisting after natural disasters, contributing to peacekeeping, undertaking border surveillance and protection duties, working on with some of the most technologically advanced equipment in the world. STEM skills are critical to assist with all elements of the Australian Defence Force's work, including reasoning, problem solving, application of rigorous analysis and objective and critical thinking skills. STEM skills also help you to resolve real world problems through critical thinking and problem solving. On behalf of the Australian Defence Force, I would like to congratulate Gabriella Wahib for her awesome achievement in being selected to receive the ADF Future Innovators Award. Thank you. Thank you for inviting me also as a representative of the Australian Defence Force to present the 2022 Longtown Youth Leadership and Teamwork Awards. Leadership is about relationships and achieving something that is beyond the individual. During the Battle of Longtown, Australian soldiers achieved what most people faced with the situation would perceive as an unachievable outcome. In August of 1966, 108 Australian men found themselves outnumbered 10 to 1. They had to continue fighting in difficult conditions, dealing with monsoonal rain and lost communications. By working together and with the support of Australian, New Zealand and American artillery, they survived against a 1,000-strong battalion of Viet Cong. This took loyalty, commitment to each other, courage and bravery in the face of personal harm. No doubt there was some innovation when resources became low, and there would have been instinctive teamwork. Professional soldiers trusting one another and working towards collective purpose, and that was to survive. Leadership is about inspiring a willing commitment from others to strive towards a goal. I'm here today because good leadership is by no means unique to the Australian Defence Force. It is on display in everyday life. It can be observed on the sporting field, in the school grounds, and in the community. I'd like to recognise Cynthia Leong as someone who has demonstrated leadership qualities and values in line with the Australian Defence Force. Thank you.
Thank you, Warren Officer Jason Ayres. Thank you. Our next award is the Archbishop of Sydney Award for Student Excellence. And I would like to invite to the stage Chloe Kalagarakis to announce this award.
The Archbishop of Sydney Awards for Student Excellence is an annual recognition of the outstanding young women and men of faith in our Catholic schools. The award highlights the positive contribution that young people make to our school and local communities. The award specifically recognises those students in Year 12 who give witness to their Catholic values and contribute actively to the faith life of the school and parish. These young people show reasonable participation in their life, mission and work of the Catholic faith community. Our recipient actively participates in the faith life of the college and parish community. She brings her faith to life in her regular participation in math and monthly youth initiatives, including Sunday Catechesis. She holds a strong passion for social justice, evidenced in her contributions to initiatives at the college, and is characterized by her service to the poor and oppressed in the broader community. She draws on her deep faith in her daily life, and her presence influences others in the community to follow her. The recipient for the Archbishop's Award for Student Excellence is Tatiana Attard.
Our next award is the Principal's Art Award, and I invite Miss Melissa Nutter to the stage.
The Principal's Art Award was established in 2019 to recognise the incredible talent of our Year 12 Visual Arts students. This year, we have joint recipients of this award. The first recipient of the Principal's Art Award goes to Nikita Agrarathoral. As Nikita's coming to the stage, I'm just going to read her artwork, which is titled Leaden Circles. Nikita wrote, "The desirability of fantasy can become parasitic to our interactions with reality. Isolation, hardships, and trauma can lead to the extreme craving of escaping reality, a danger that has clawed at many in our society facing the burden of COVID, flooding, and international warfare. When reality is tainted, many turn inwards into imagination. Intuition guided my practice in expressing these inward ideas in a cathartic manner. Charcoal encapsulates this with its messy nature. Smudging, layering, and bold mark making leading to unexpected results. Circular motifs are present throughout, symbolising the cyclical nature of post-truth anxieties and how they burden individuals with the guilt of complacency." Thank you, Nikita. Our second recipient of the Principal's Art Award is Imogen Lucas. And as Imogen makes her way to the stage, her artwork titled Encrusted with Salt and Speckled with Sand. Growing up by the coast, the sea for me has always been a release from the mundane and the monotony. Thus, my body of work has enabled me to create these joyful moments made on, under and around the ocean, whilst expressing the harshness yet the wonder in both the Australian landscapes and Australian surf culture. The merging of numerous mediums, collage, paint, crayon, film photography and pencil, has allowed me to explore the merging of lives on land and in the sea. The mark making was inspired by Cubism to create a tribute to the movement and the blissful chaos of coastal living. The playful compositions and bright colours attempt to allow the viewer a moment to relish in the beauty and the joy embedded in all our realities. Congratulations, Imogen. Thank you, Miss Nutter. Our next award is the Sister Helen Connolly Memorial Music Award. This award is given in memory of Sister Helen Connolly, who was principal at Brigidine from 1981 to 1988. This award recognises a student who has shown a strong commitment to the musical life of the college. This student has demonstrated her commitment to music through her involvement in both the junior and college orchestras as a flutist, her participation in the college choir, and her leadership of the a cappella group. This student is a great musical all-rounder. The recipient of the Sister Helen Connolly Memorial Music Award in 2022 is Abigail Connolly. Our next award is the Cedric Ashton Award for Musical Excellence. This award is given in memory of Cedric Ashton, who was a member of the Sydney Symphony Orchestra and a cello tutor at Brigidine College. This student has demonstrated her commitment to music through her dedication as a skilled musician, who has shared her talents as a horn player for both the junior and college orchestras, and her commitment to practice and performance and her expertise as a highly skilled pianist. In 2022, the Cedric Ashton Award for Musical Excellence is presented to Mira Jackson. The Senior Oratory Award is presented to the student who has shown consistent commitment to both debating and oratory at Brigidine. This year's recipient of the Senior Oratory Award is Tatiana Attard. Our next award is the Jan Foley Award. This award is named in honour of Mrs. Jan Foley, who was the principal of Brigidine College from 2000 to 2007. The Jan Foley Award is presented to a girl who has demonstrated perseverance, positivity, and an ever-engaging smile in spite of a number of challenges during her time at Brigidine. The 2022 recipient of the Jan Foley Award is Sophia Vedder. Our next award is the Diana Hitchens Award for Community Service and is named in honour of Diana Hitchens, who was a much-loved member of our college community. Our 2022 recipient not only has outstanding potential, but she continually reinforces the same broad-ranging dedication to her academic and community endeavours. This year, the Diana Hitchens Award for Community Service is presented to Leah Doyle. Our next awards are our Kildare Awards. The Kildare Awards recognise those girls who have contributed to our community with generosity and initiative, always aware of keeping the spirit of St. Bridget alive in our community. The Kildare Award recipients are Ginevra Aelio, Genevieve Beach, Yeah.
Christelle Cabrera. Ciara Cameron. Julia Deduciak. Joyful Fotomoala. Chloe Kalajarakis. Samantha Kay. Chelsea Leong. Alice Norbury. Levi Norrish. Charlotte Pince Award. Sienna Reiners. Maria Richards. Audrey Sito. Simeon Stevens. Sophie Von Willer. Girls, I just ask you to stay there. From our Kildare Awards, we draw our Bishop Delaney Awards. The recipients of this award are an exemplary embodiment of the Kildare Awards. It is my pleasure to announce Julia Dejusiak and Simeon Stevens. Thank you, girls. Our next award is the St. Bridget's Cup for contribution to the religious life of the college. This award is awarded to a student who has made a consistent and enthusiastic effort to promote gospel values. The recipient of the St. Bridget's Cup, Religious Life of the College, is Giovanni Delaguet. The Principal's Award for Special Contribution to College Life recognises a student who has shown exemplary commitment, character, citizenship, service and leadership. The recipient of this award is Eve Payne. The Founders Cup for Initiative and Service acknowledges a student who has shown both qualities of initiative and service during her senior years at the college. The student is a prominent student in both college and community projects. The Founders Cup for Initiative and Service in 2022 is awarded to Ruby Thomasieu. Our next award is the Principal's Award for Leadership and Outstanding Contribution to the College. This is awarded to a student who is generous with her time and who has much to promote the welfare of the College through her successful involvement in and leadership of college activities. This year's recipient has provided outstanding leadership and contribution to Bridgerton College on a continual and exemplary basis throughout 2022. The recipient of the Leadership and Outstanding Contribution to College Life Award is Mira Jackson. Our next award is the College Cup for Outstanding Efforts in Studies. The College Cup for Outstanding Efforts in Studies recognises the exceptional way in which a student has approached her studies. The recipient of this award has been consistent in her academic efforts and application throughout Year 11 and 12. The College Cup for Outstanding Efforts in Studies is awarded to Genevieve Beach. The final special award and Bridgerton College's most prestigious major award is the Fortiter e Suaviter Award for All-Round Excellence. This award recognises a student at the college who exemplifies the qualities espoused in our motto, Fortiter e Suaviter, to act with strength and gentleness. The recipient of this award is a truly inspirational student who is genuine and sincere in her commitment to the college. She has been a truly inspirational student, and she leaves this college with a legacy that will remain forever enshrined in the college spirit and the very fabric of Bridgerton College.
it gives me great pleasure to announce that the recipient of the 2022 Portatoire et Suaviter Award is Cynthia Leong. I would now like to call to the stage Mira Jackson to address the graduating class of 2022.
Congratulations. Today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off and away. You've got brains in your head. You've got feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. Good afternoon, Mrs. Quirk, staff, families, invited guests, and the Year 12 graduating class of 2022. Today, the 21st of September, marks not only our graduation day, but also World Gratitude Day. So to begin with, I am extremely grateful to be standing here today delivering this final address. As a college captain for 2022, I look back into the past 12 months with immense gratitude. And when reflecting, I can truly say it's been the best time of my life. The year was 2010, starting kindy. Our 13 years of schooling had just begun. The year was 2016, graduating primary school. We thought life couldn't get any better. Our biggest worries were if we could survive the mannequin challenge, win the floor is lava game, or be the best at bottle flipping. The year was 2017, and we were walking into the Bridgetine gates for the very first time. We were scared to spend the next 6 years with people we had never met. We were hopeful, curious, and energetic. We didn't know what the future would hold. The year was 2018 and 2019, one comment. We were cool in our own eyes. The year was 2020 and we were introduced to online learning. The year was 2021 and our senior years had just begun. The year is 2022 and very soon we will be walking out of the Bridgetine gates for the very last time. We are scared to leave the people we have spent 6 years with, but we have the same sense of hope and curiosity that we had all those years ago. And for many of us, we still don't know what the future holds. In my opinion, school wasn't about just learning from the textbook. With the guidance of our amazing teachers, we learnt how to embody the Bridgetine values of strength and gentleness into our daily routine. As we reflect on our time here, we know that these teachers, these outstanding educators, help shape us as individuals. As we progress into stage six, it became even clearer that our teachers became figures who were catalysts in helping us achieve our goals. People who gave us confidence in our abilities, people who gave us courage to overcome stress and anxiety, and most importantly, people who gave us love and support. The impact that these teachers have had on our lives is something that can't be measured, but rather it is defined by our actions, how we treat others, and what we'll achieve in our lives. This year, we especially give thanks to all the teachers who put endless hours into our work, checking our essays late at night and staying for afternoon or morning classes. On that note, I'd like to thank every teacher and supporting staff for their constant belief in us and their tremendous dedication to our education and learning journey. To Mrs. Quirk and the college executive team, thank you. As a naturally reserved and shy person, I'm grateful for the faith you had in me. You've allowed me to lead with passion whilst encouraging me to adopt a leadership style that expressed who I am. Thank you for your guidance and support, especially over this past year. Over my time at Brigidine, I've witnessed your dedication and commitment to the school community, always showing support at every school event, whether it be sports, music, debating, or public speaking. Thank you for also providing our year group with endless opportunities to assist us with our studies, including all the after-school hours spent in the library and organising numerous workshops. The work you do behind the scenes is phenomenal, and without you all, events such as today would not be possible. Thank you. To Mrs. Borg. First of all, happy Wednesday. Over the last 2 years, we've been so fortunate to have you guide our year group. Your positivity and enthusiasm have seamlessly merged into the school community, and you've become a figure that we admire in so many aspects of life. Thank you for supplying tea and hot water, and for possibly being the fastest teacher to respond to any email. Your guidance, support, and teaching, such as with every right comes a responsibility, find your manners and find them quick, and be kind, have been inspirational. And I think it's safe to say that you really are a Borgonator. We appreciate everything you've done to assist us with managing our workload, whilst also ensuring that our year was as enjoyable as possible. From listening to all our questions and simply checking in on us, you reassured us that we were on this journey together. Your commitment to our year group and ensuring our well-being is your top priority is a true testament to your selfless nature. Whilst I'm sure you won't miss the constant bombardment of students in your office or our endless repetitive questions, we hope that is your first and last Year 12 graduating class at Brigidine. We've made you proud. Thank you for also guiding the leadership team. You always approached our leadership meetings with an open mind, facilitated any ideas that we suggested, and always ensured us leaders were an active part in the community. I've been so privileged to have worked so closely with you this year. So on behalf of Year 12, I'm so grateful to have had you as our year coordinator for our senior years. You've been a blessing in our lives. To my fellow student leadership team, I'm thankful to have been part of such an amazing group of people. Despite the challenges associated with COVID restrictions at the beginning of the year, we've been able to create a positive change within the community. We've been able to instigate one of the largest fundraisers Brigidine has seen, the Ponytail Project, and raise over $28,000 for the Cancer Council in the span of less than 2 weeks. We have held possibly one too many bake sales and brought back past events such as the Brigidine Talent Show. I'm so incredibly proud of what we've accomplished throughout our journey, and I hope we've created a lasting legacy in Brigidine history. To Cynthia, my partner in crime and the outstanding college vice captain, I have loved doing this leadership journey with you, and it has been such an honour to lead Brigidine with you by my side. To Yasmin, Emily, and the student leadership team of 2023, I wish you all the best of luck as you lead the school next year. I'm so excited for you all, and I can't wait to see what you achieve. On behalf of all the Year 12 students, I'd also like to thank our families. Without your support, the HSC is simply impossible. Even though at times I'm sure we've driven you to near insanity, just remember the best is yet to come. Thank you for all the lunches packed, pickups and drop-offs, all the notes you've signed, navigating compass, and the unconditional love, support and wisdom you have shared. You've given us the gift of education. Thank you for believing in us when we didn't believe in ourselves. Thank you for guiding our way when the light wasn't as bright for us. And thank you for the endless sacrifices that have been made to ensure that we are graduating in this hall today. On a more personal note, thank you to my family, my parents, and my siblings. I am eternally grateful for your constant support this year. Thank you for the opportunities you've provided me and for instilling within me a strong passion for learning. Congrats, Mom and Dad, you got all four of us through high school. And to the graduating class of 2022, as the years go by, our friendship will never die because you've got a friend in me. As the only year group that has gone through a record number of year coordinators, from Ms. McColl, Ms. Playuse, Ms. Foster, Ms. Aloisi, Ms. Georges, and finally Ms. Borg. Maybe it's time that we do some self-reflection and consider what we've done to drive them away. But from this experience, we've learnt perseverance, and most importantly, we've hopefully grown up from what Ms. Georges called our rebellion year 9 and 10 years. As a year group, we have made memories of the years that will last us a lifetime. For some, it could have been innocently witnessing the main quad fence come tumbling down in 2017, or the memories created at our first Year 7 camp. Maybe it was the memories created at retreat, or maybe it'll be our final night at Formage together, where we'll be able to witness Mr. Wilson's iconic dance moves. As Year 12s, we embarked on our final year with optimism and hope, determined to make our final one year one to remember and praying that COVID would not ruin our last year together. To the lows of exams, to the highs of finishing exams, I've loved every minute with you all. And as Tay-Tay Swift said, long live the walls we crashed through, I had the time of my life. Our routines are about to change forever. No longer will we need to find ways to get out of Thursday sport, nor will we have to present a facade of listening and taking notes and lessons. No longer will we get a static shock whilst at our lockers, nor will we have to dodge the bin chickens eating our food. We won't ever be able to see Miss Muhammad's bright orange teacher union shirt again, nor will we be able to compete with Miss Agatsi's incredibly fast-paced walking in her high heels. But in all seriousness, no longer will we see each other every day, 5 times a week, on the bell, before or after school, or smile as we walk past each other in the hallways. The teachers that have been role models and part of our everyday routine now become figures in someone else's. But this end today marks the beginning of a new chapter, a new journey, and new opportunities. And as we nestle down in exam preparation, or begin our exam preparation, irrespective of how far we travel one day, we know that the friendships in this room will never change. To Year 12, there isn't anything I won't do for you. We stick together and see it through because you've got a friend in me. Now, the end of our careers as students, we have an opportunity. Now is our time to strengthen the friendships that we have created and to find and pursue our passions. And as we all embark on our individual journeys, remember that your success is not defined by the opportunities that you're given, but it's defined by what you make of them. And just remember, when the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, just remember what your old captain said, you've got a friend in me. Graduation is a bittersweet moment. When you think about all the new opportunities available to you after high school, including starting uni, traveling, or even wearing whatever jewelry you want, there is so much excitement. But when you think about leaving the people who've been so instrumental in your life, there is also a great amount of sadness. At what point in life are you forced to move on from people who've made you who you are today? But then again, what story finishes at just the beginning? In conclusion, if you take anything away from today, just remember that you've all got a friend in me. It's been a true honour and privilege to be your college captain for 2022 and to represent this amazing school. I'm so grateful to have had this opportunity and I thank you all for your belief in me. I'm so proud of everyone here and I could not have asked for a better group of people to spend my high school years with. And just remember, girls can do anything, but Bridgetine girls can do everything except divide by zero. We stand here today on the precipice of the future. It's not a distant reality anymore. It begins here, it begins today. The year is 2022 and we have officially graduated high school. So be your name, Mira, Myra, or Mira. You're off to great places, you're off and away. Today is your day, your mountain is waiting, so go get on your way. But before I officially end, Cynthia and I would now like to perform a little something on the piano and violin. It's called You've Got a Friend in Me. Please feel free to sing along to cover up any mistakes that we make. Thank you, Cynthia. So, to the class of 2022, may I ask you to please stand up. You please stand. Remove your cap and hold it in your hand. We did it. Congratulations. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, this now concludes our graduation ceremony. In a moment, I will ask you to stand so that we can applaud as the girls leave. And I'd just like to let you know that Mass will commence sharply at 5:10. So that should give you time to walk straight up to the church. So ladies and gentlemen, can we please stand? And I ask you to applaud the graduating class of 2022. Ladies and gentlemen, please make your way to the church. And as I said, we will commence sharply at 5:10. Thank you.